Hey everyone and welcome back to Let's Play XCOM 2. So, let's continue where we left off and go back to the bridge, I guess. Not much else to do right now, we are still waiting for a few things. Intel, yes, I wouldn't mind that. However, we need the supply drop first. For obvious reasons, I think. The supply drop is always priority. We'll go for the intel after. And we can maybe check the black market while we're at it. Now, I still need to build a comms tower. I need a comms tower in Asia. So, the only region it makes sense in is East Asia. Anyway, we finished clearing the alien machinery, so now we can get started on the shadow chamber. Probably somewhere around here. Let's have a look. That's 125 supplies. Well, we need it, so might as well get started. Yep, let's get started. How long will it take? Only 7 days, that's fine. I do need a workshop somewhere in the middle, however, we also need quite a few upgrades in Guerrilla Tactics School, and we should go for that. There are a few really useful ones here. I'd like to get Vulture, that's additional item, every time enemies drop loot. I wouldn't mind Vengeance, no, stay with me. Yeah, soldiers will be more likely to bleed out than die. The problem is that this costs 150 supplies. Vengeance isn't bad. I would also like the biggest bombs. I think we want biggest bombs. Being able to get crits with explosives is just so nice. Alright, let's get the biggest bombs and I think we'll go for Vulture. Alright, fine. And that's that. That leaves us with 29 supplies. Back to the bridge. And let's get our supply drop. There, we got... how much? 92, I think. New stuff available. Alright, we got 121 supplies. I think we just need to get a comms tower over here. We have to wait for resistance comms anyway. Or we could go for the supplies over here. That's not a terrible idea, I suppose. And then we could grab the intel. Let's go get the supplies. I think resistance comms are almost done. Let's see. Yeah, one more day. And we finished Ellerium research. Nice one. So this unlocks Ellerium conduit. That's a new facility upgrade, apparently. Not sure what that does. More power? New research available, plasma rifle and powered armor. Yep, we kind of want both. Yeah, that's just an upgrade for the power relay, alright. So, what do we want next? I wouldn't mind psionics, but I'm kind of tempted to go for either weapons or armor. The problem is that we probably won't have the money for this right away. I think we'll go for psionics. The problem with that is that we'll also need the Psylab. We'll need money for all of these things. It might be better to go for intel. That will take 7 days, but yeah. I might go for intel. Alright, let's go for intel. And we can check the black market. See if there's anything interesting. Let's finish the destroy convoy first. And we got resistance comms, nice one. Okay. But let's finish that convoy. There we go, 72 supplies. We'll check out the black market. See if there's anything we can buy. I think it refreshed by now. I'm not sure actually. Market is open. Yes, it did refresh, so what can we get? We could get a sharpshooter. We could get supplies. Superior agility. I do like superior agility. Superior autoloader, laser sight. Yeah, superior laser sight is kind of nice. I will get the supplies, because the ratio is just so good. We could rush psionics research. It might be worth it. Maybe. I'm not entirely convinced. I mean, we're going to spend 7 days to get intel from research. Spending intel to then rush psionics is a little bit silly. If I wanted to get psionics faster, it would be more efficient to just research psionics first. So, yeah. I mean, I could always just switch to psionics and rush research at the same time, but nah. Anyway, I think we want superior agility. That's extra movement. 30 intel. I think it's worth it. And do I want a sharpshooter for 80 intel? Not necessarily. We'll have to spend 80 intel to make contact with new territory. Can we sell anything? Not really. They are only interested in Advent Mechrec. I mean, I could always sell things they aren't interested in, but I'd rather not. Oh yeah, superior agility is not movement, it's extra dodge, but that's not bad. What was the other mod? Oh, there wasn't one, just one PCS. Okay. Let's move on. I think we'll just make contact with East Africa. We have to reach one of the facilities. They both have the same exact progress, so it doesn't really matter what we'll go for. The North America bonus reduces the intel cost at the black market, but East Africa has way more connections. Yeah, it's connected to multiple territories, as you can see. We can expand into Africa, or we can expand into Europe after we get that. I think East Africa is better. So this will cost us 80 intel, but building a comms tower here wouldn't really make any sense, because then it would be adjacent to an existing tower. I do need a tower in Asia, but it will make more sense to build it here. Because if we get a facility in New Indonesia, it would cost us 120. That's a little bit too much. So the plan is to go for East Africa for 80 intel, and we'll build a tower in East Asia and then in Africa. East Africa is connected to multiple territories, so this will be the best location for a comms tower, that's how I feel. We got blue screen protocol, so this will unlock the EMP grenades and blue screen rounds. These do way more damage to robotic enemies. What can we do now? I still want advanced explosives, we could go for that. Oh yeah, we should get battlefield medicine, I think. Alright, let's go for that. I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander. And the shadow chamber is almost done, kind of. I think that's it for now. Back to the bridge. How much would it cost us to upgrade this? Alright, I'll keep that in mind. We don't need extra power just yet. Let's continue. And new targets acquired. Oh yeah, guerrilla ops. Dr. Christopher Odd, scientist. Alright then. Ranger. Ooh, not bad. And 184 supplies. So this is a tough choice. I'm not quite sure which dark event I want to counter. If this was a major breakthrough, I would probably counter this. Grantees reinforcements on all guerrilla ops. Reduces retaliation counter by 2 weeks. Maybe. I think we can deal with retaliation just fine at the moment. I might go for the ranger. That's a lieutenant ranger. That's pretty damn good. I like it. And it seems this mission is actually easier. Not that this is really a factor for me, but I wouldn't mind a more experienced ranger. I really like this one. I think we'll go for New India. And we'll counter Avatar Project Progress. But this is more about the ranger, honestly. Okay, let's go for this one. Off we go. And I think Mark is still wounded. Let's remove everyone first. And we'll redo our squad. Is Mark still wounded? No, he's not. No one is wounded, nice. Okay, Mark is definitely coming. And I'll bring Joe as well. Actually, I could still bring Boris, but he's already a sergeant. Yeah, let's just bring Joe. We got three specialists right now. I wouldn't mind another specialist with the medic build. Joe's build, basically. I like having two specialists on one mission. Right, more. We need a grenadier, at least one. So that's going to be Brian, I suppose. This should be a fairly easy mission. So, who else? Another grenadier. I could bring Cactus to maybe get him promoted to sergeant. Sure, why not? And we could bring Neil, or we could bring a less experienced sharpshooter, or I could bring two rangers. I think I prefer two rangers, honestly. Yeah. Alright, this is fine. Now, let's give them proper gear. Who's going to use the EXO yacht? I might give it to a grenadier, actually. Let's see. Hold on. So we do have the salvo ability on Brian. And this does work with the EXO yacht. Which means we could use the rocket launcher and it will not end our turn. I do like that a lot. I think we might go for that setup. Like this. And he can still bring three grenades. Two in this slot and one in this slot. I think that's the best way to go. Yeah, I like this setup. It's a good one. Hold on, one more thing. Does volatile mix work with a rocket? No, your grenades have an increased range and deal plus 2 damage, so I assume this will not work with a rocket. That's still fine. It's nice with salvo. Alright. We'll go with this. Now, we need a mimic beacon on someone. What about the Skulljack? I should give Skulljack to Mark. Do they not have the same base hacking skill now? 75 and 75. Yeah, they both have the same exact base hacking skill. So it doesn't really matter. It matters in the sense that Mark has Haywire Protocol. And the Skulljack will increase his hacking skill. So the Skulljack is actually better on Mark. Yeah, it is. Okay, Mark will use that then. Like so. Mimic beacon for Joe. That's probably fine. What else? I wouldn't mind the battle scanner. What about the dragon rounds? I think I prefer that on someone else. So battle scanner, or we could give him a plasma grenade. We do want a battle scanner on someone though. And there's no one inexperienced in here. Okay, battle scanner for Mark. I like having it. Anything else? We still got dragon rounds, so might as well give them to Vasily. That's fine. And I think we're ready. I don't see any more changes here. Yep, this is fine. Let's go then. I guess we should expect Archons in these missions now, because we had one in the previous one. And Archons have a pretty high chance to dodge, from what I know. Similar to Vipers, I think. I don't know, Vipers have 33% chance to dodge on Commander and Legend difficulty. Operation Crypt Phase. Alright then. Well, here we are. And we started on high ground. Our objective isn't too far away. So this is where we need to go. We got 8 turns. Not that much time. We better get started. Alright, Jane will go first. Looks clear. There are some civilians nearby, but we should be okay. Probably. I don't think they will move, but they might. Let's play it safe for now. We'll jump down like this and stay over there. Next up is Vasily. Come here, Vasily. There's not a whole lot of cover that we can use around here. I'm not too excited about this. Yeah, let's not move here, because if there's a group around the corner, we'll be kind of screwed. In fact, I don't want to move too far to the right side for that exact reason. There might be a group around the corner, and that would be terrible. Come on, Vasily. I'll keep a few people on the high ground. Mostly because there's not enough cover on the low ground. Yep. There's not a whole lot of cover up here either, but we can dash to the right side. That's acceptable. Alright, come on, people. And Joe. And that's that. Overwatch. Won't really be necessary, but might as well use it anyway. And here comes the first group. Just an officer and a shield bearer. Seems easy enough. We can ambush them, no problem. I don't think we need explosives for this. Probably not, no. Who's going to initiate it? We can move towards them a bit. With Vasily. And I think Vasily will initiate the ambush. 89%, yeah, I like that. Alright, let's do it. Might want to move over with Jane a bit. I could use chain shot with Jane instead, but we would have to hit the first one. Nah, I don't think it's worth it. Okay. Do we want to jump down? I do like having high ground bonuses. Imagine that. We're not in a huge rush, we're not that far away from our objective. Yeah, let's just keep the nice high ground bonus. It will give us a higher chance to actually kill them both. Overwatch. And Vasily will initiate the ambush. Okay, go for it. Nice one, 8 damage. We should kill them both, unless we get incredibly unlucky. We're visible here. Yes, get over here. They are moving towards us. Too bad for them. And he's down already. Now we just got the shield bearer to kill. The shield bearer will die. There, he already took 4 damage. He does have some armor. Not anymore. Yep, he's dead. That was easy enough. And they dropped some loot. Nice. Enemy I'll take eliminated. It. This one might be carrying something. And we got a promotion. That's a great start of the mission. And right, that was just my cursor. We do have Vulture now, right? Okay, let's move. I could use Conceal on Vasily. It's probably worth it. We're getting close. Yep, let's use Conceal. Why not? And Jane is still concealed. I think I'll just grab the loot on the next turn. I could pick it up now if I really want to. But that seems a bit pointless.
Let's do this.
Yeah, we still got 6 turns and we are almost right next to our destination. Let's move. It should be clear on the right side. I could throw a battle scanner. I could also use scanning protocol. I think scanning protocol is the best choice in this situation. It's just a one-shot ability. We can't use it more than once per mission. Let's use it. That ability is so amazing. Okay, there's a group right next to the van, which is to be expected. Looks like that's a snack. Yep. Okay then. Let's move, people. So, I could just pick up that loot, but again, there's no point. We won't really achieve anything by doing that. And it's risky. Let's not do that. We can still move up a bit. I don't want to trigger that group. But it's fine to move like this. Slightly to the left. And Overwatch. Looks good. And now we can pick up the loot. Hopefully we'll get something nice. Give me something good. We got... okay. Advanced conditioning, plus 2 health. Nice. I like that. I need to think about who exactly to use the combat sims on. We got quite a few. I just need to think about which one will be best used on which class and person. They can't be removed. They can be replaced, but they can't be removed, so it's a pretty important decision. Anyway, I'm strongly considering a rocket launcher. Maybe, or we could just trigger it the old-fashioned way. We can just ambush it. I don't see why not. I think we'll do that. Yep, we'll just ambush it. And we could check our hacking options. But if I hack right now, I will trigger that group, because they will see the bot. Let's just move closer, this is still fine. There they are, there's a Muton and two Vipers. Shouldn't be too hard, but Vipers have 33% chance to dodge, and it's pretty annoying. I think we'll set up an ambush from back here. Okay, we can check hacking options on the left side. Unless there's a group over there, but there shouldn't be. This might be something useful for our next fight. Let's have a look. Okay. Disorient enemies for 2 turns. 96%, holy crap. Gain control of a random enemy. Yeah, we'll go for this one, but not yet. That's amazing. 96% chance. Okay, I'll keep that in mind. Let's move a little bit closer, just not too close. Let's see. Yeah, I don't want them to see me, obviously. We'll stay back here, and we'll trigger the ambush on the next turn. Mark needs to be a bit closer. And looks good, so overwatch on everyone. Not really necessary, but what else are we going to do? I suppose we could reload at least some of our weapons. Oh, they are actually moving. Okay then, so overwatch was actually useful. I thought it's going to be a stationary group. Not that I really mind. They triggered the ambush, that's what matters.
That didn't do much.
And we still got a lot of explosives. I wonder if it's possible to blow up the objective. Well, they are moving away from the van, so that's good. Yeah, the dodge is pretty annoying, I have to say. Come on, people, more shots. Any more shots?
Yeah,
no?
I didn't get it.
Really? That's it? Come on now. I think it's time to do some hacking. Yep, I think so. So, I think it's Mark who should do it. Well, if I do it with Joe, I'll have combat protocol with Mark, and we can already use combat protocol to kill the snake. Yep, it might not even be necessary. So actually, let's do it like this. We'll try to kill all of them, and if we fail to do that, then we'll use the disorient. But there's a good chance it won't even be necessary at all. So Brian can move a bit closer. And plasma grenade. Not sure if it's worth using it, but it will kill... Well, we have a lot of grenades, might as well use it. Go, go, go. I don't think we'll need the disorient, no. Oh yeah, we have biggest bombs now, 9 damage to the snake. We will not need disorient. We'll kill that Muton, no problem. We can almost flank the Muton, but not quite. Jane can hit him in the face. She will obviously get revealed, but that doesn't really matter all that much. What about Vasily? He can take a shot first. Well, not really. Okay, Jane. She will get revealed, but that doesn't matter at all. She probably won't kill him in one shot. I could also try to shred him first. That's not a bad plan. Can we actually shred him? No. Yes. Joe has shredder armor. Okay. Just move a bit closer. He won't have amazing chance to hit. But he does have shredder ammo. Yeah, 23% is kind of crap. It's not even worth taking that shot. I'd rather reload, honestly. Alright, just take a shot with Jane. 100%. And... 5 damage, I think. We can still use combat protocol. Combat protocol will actually kill him right now. That's 4 damage that goes through armor. You know, combat protocol is actually a little bit too good, I think. Yeah, it's a little bit too good. It goes through armor, which is kind of crazy, if you think about it. This basically equals to 6 guaranteed damage. Because that's what it was. That was 6 guaranteed damage. Because it bypassed armor. It's a little bit too good. Not that I mind. I don't mind at all. Alright, let's move. There's no need to dash towards the van. There might be more groups around there. We'll play it safe. Okay, no cover we can dash into. We can still use the disorient. If we get more groups. Well, I mean, we will get at least one more group. Because that's one of our goals. Oh, I should have moved there. Damn it. Well, whatever, we're fine. That detonator isn't going to wait. Get to the vault and disarm it. It's okay, Bradford. We got this. Don't worry. Right, should have avoided that damage, but what's done is done. We'll just heal up. So let's move and heal up. But that's Joe's job. Come on, Joe. Make your gremlin useful, thanks. There. Come on, go, go. Almost back to full health. And let's go grab our objective. I think we need to go through the back, yep. So, I could use conceal again. That's probably worth it. And there's a group over there. Alright, oh, they got a codex. Right. Let's have a look. We should be able to do some good damage. Now we could use disorient. It's probably worth doing it right now. But let's see how much damage we can do first. We still got the rocket launcher. But in this situation, the plasma grenade will be better. Or maybe not. We can't quite reach them. No, the rocket launcher will be better. Yep, let's use the rocket launcher. We might be able to kill the codex. There we go. And now we can take a shot at the codex. It will clone, which is pretty annoying. But we got 100%. We should kill the codex for sure. That is the most dangerous enemy over here. Alright, go for it, Jane. There, it's down. Rip.
Impressed yet?
Now, we still got one more in the back. We're almost at the zone wall at this point. So, Vasily. What can Vasily do? He can move up a bit. And possibly take a shot. Only 40% on the trooper. That's not amazing. He can't reach him with a grenade. Unfortunately. Okay, then. So, what about that disorient? I think we should just use it. With Mark. I honestly think that's our best option here. Yep, let's just disorient them. It's not like we'll use it on anything else. We're almost done with this entire mission. 96%. There, we got it. It was technically possible to fail. We had 66% chance to gain control of a random unit. But disorient is a safer option. So now they are all disoriented. We can still try to kill one. We're just too far away to use a grenade launcher. Or take a shot with Mark. I can only take a shot with Vasily. That's all I can do. Might be better to keep him concealed. Yeah, let's move towards the van. We still need to get our objective, you know. And Overwatch, in case they decide to move towards us. Alright then. Come on, people. So the codex will move up a bit. And shoot someone, most likely. Yep. Wow. These two guys shouldn't be too dangerous. The shield bearer might use his shield thing. Or not. Oh, he actually hit Mark. That's fine. We got more than enough armor and health. One last guy. Yep, we are fine. That was close. Everything is under control. Let's just kill them now. Can we skulljack one of them? No, we're too far away. Alright, whatever.
Absolutely.
Let's do it then. We still got command protocol. So that's basically a guaranteed kill on the codex. Yep, let's go for that. Seriously, combat protocol is just too good. Not only it does so much guaranteed damage, you don't even need line of sight. You don't even have to be in range. It's just insane. This is easily one of the best abilities in the game. And there are some really good ones. Right. Let's just kill them all. This might complete the mission. Maybe. I mean, we still need to grab our objective, I suppose. Anyway, let's just run towards that guy and kill him. This should be a kill, unless we get unlucky. 100%. Come on, Vasily, take a shot. What are you waiting for? Yes, I'm talking to you. What the heck?
Menace 1-5, this is Avenger. We have positive.
Yes, we know Bradford. Can we kill this guy yet? That would be great. There we go. That was funny. 13 critical. One more guy. So, yeah, I'd like to grab the objective. We can just do it right now. Let's kill this dude. Joe can take a shot. Joe doesn't have combat protocol. He's a healer build. We still didn't even use the Mimic Beacon because it wasn't necessary, honestly. The Mimic Beacon is our insurance policy. That's what it is. For really tough situations. That's what I'm saving it for. Oh yeah, I could have used demolition over here. I can still do it. Maybe? I could also just kill him with a grenade or something.
Order's confirmed. On the move.
Yeah, let's just kill him with a grenade.
If you say so.
Not that it really matters. Yeah, whatever. Kill him with a grenade. We might get one more group, but if we do, we have more than enough tools to handle it. And he's down. Let's go get the thing.
We're not picking up further contacts near your position.
Yep, I think we're actually done.
Move on the target before the charges detonate.
Yeah, we're moving in. Don't worry, Bradford. It's fine.
Sure thing.
We'll get it on the next turn. Okay, so Overwatch still, in case they get reinforcements. It's fine, Bradford. We got it. I told you. Just relax.
No problem. I'm elite.
Oh yeah, we should probably use one of our hacker dudes. Yeah, to have a higher chance to get the materials. So let's let me do that. Are they close enough to get line of sight? No, actually yeah, I think they are. Because we blew it up partially? No, they actually aren't, damn it. Well, that's slightly unfortunate, but oh well. Let's finish this then. It doesn't matter that much. Let's go for the 15%. We actually got it, that's funny. Alright. Hey, I'll take it. That was Vasily, yeah? Graz Vasily, you're a hacker now. And we're done. I assume. There, we're done. Two soldiers wounded. One was kind of my fault, but whatever. It's fine. They won't be wounded for more than a few days. And it will give someone else a chance to get experience. I will probably hire a few more rookies soon. We got a few rookies from my character pool in the armory. I just need money for facilities right now. Alright, we got at least one promotion. Yep, there it is. That's going to be... I might go for suppression again. Yep, let's go for suppression. Only Roland had suppression so far. And that's that. So we got plus 2 health, I need to think about who to use it on.
Hello, Commander.
And we got the Ranger, right. That's quite nice. And we countered Avatar Project Progress. And our new Ranger is a Lieutenant. I like that. Oh yeah, that's also a guy from my character pool. Nice. So... promotions. I could go for a different build, but honestly... the Ranger build I'm using right now is working so nice. I see no real reason to change it. Phantom is just so good. I wouldn't go for Blademaster. I mean, right now the problem with melee weapons is that they are weaker than the shotgun. The only reason to ever use a melee weapon right now is to use the skills that require a melee weapon. But there's no reason to use it for actual damage, for base damage, because the damage is lower than the shotgun. The shotgun has a much greater potential. But yeah, Phantom is just so good, so I would definitely go for Phantom. Shadow Step is nice. I'm not using Shadow Step that much, but it's one of these abilities that you don't need a lot of the time, but when you do need it, it's just so nice to have it. Shadow Strike is also good. I mean, with a Shadow Strike and with a scope that adds critical chance, whatever it's called, we could get very close to 100% chance to crit. So that's one thing to consider. I might consider Shadow Strike. It might actually be worth it. But then I will definitely go for Conceal. Run and Gun is good, but Conceal is so nice too, especially combined with Shadow Strike. Yeah, the only thing I would change is maybe Shadow Strike instead of Shadow Step, to have it on at least one person, but I'm keeping the other abilities the way they are. Okay, so Phantom. And let's go for Shadow Strike, to have it on at least one person. Yep, I'm okay with this. Then we'll go for Conceal, and let's mod him right away. So, right, we do have quite a few here. We only got one superior perception, but weapon upgrade first. So, since we got Shadow Strike, we could give him superior laser sight, which is increased chance to crit. That's 30, so 55 with a plus 25. Yeah, he will get very close to 100. This is fine. Actually, he will get 100 because superior laser sight gets an even higher crit boost with proximity. So, okay, superior laser sight. Anything else for him? Probably not. No, this is fine for now. Yep, this is fine. We'll give expanded magazine to Neil, or does he already have it? No, he doesn't, so we'll give him the expanded magazine, because that's just so good with Killzone. So it makes sense in my book. Yep, sounds good. I still haven't decided which ability to go for here. These are both good in different situations. I'll probably go for aim. I don't know. It's a tough decision, really. Steady hands is a little bit more universal, but you can use aim after moving. And with as many timed missions as there are, moving is kind of necessary. That's the problem with snipers in XCOM 2. I don't value snipers that high, because you have to move a lot of the time. You can't just camp one position. And leaving a sniper way behind is not a great idea either. So I actually think aim is going to be better. Alright, let's go for aim. There, it's decided. Done. And that's that. So, Shadow Chamber is almost done. Let's check the armory real quick. Wounded for 5 days and 4 days. Yep, that's fine. Back to the bridge. What can we do now? Oh yeah, we are still making contact. we can get a scientist. Well, I'd like to finish making contact with East Africa, because that's what we were doing in the first place. And I'd like to build a tower in here, because I will want a tower in here anyway. Might as well build it before we make contact with the next region. This is the same exact animation every single time, so whatever. Right, so now we can reach Eastern Europe, which is where the facility is. We can also reach West Africa and South Africa. And we will build a tower here. Otherwise, making contact with Eastern Europe would cost us 120 intel. There's no need to waste intel like that. However, we're going to do that in the next episode. Thanks for watching this one, and I'll see you next time.